Family of a man who was run over and killed outside an Omaha party seeks a change in state law.
That family feels the man charged in the case may get off too easy. He is Travis Wolf, charged with manslaughter, not felony motor vehicle homicide. Prosecutors must pursue the lesser charge because Wolf left the scene. And there is no way to know if he was drunk when he allegedly hit Scott Limbeck. KETV News Watch 7's Jeff Van Sant joins us live.
Now, Travis Wolf is free on bond and ordered this evening to stand trial for manslaughter. It's frustrating to the victims' families who want Wolf's prosecuted on a tougher charge, a move state law will not allow. Travis Wolf leaves the courtroom free again on bond, but still facing manslaughter charges for what happened outside an Omaha party in January. Wolf is accused of deliberately running over Scott Limbeck, then driving away. This was the first time Limbeck's sister, Carrie Copenharve, ever seen the man accused of killing her brother.
That was a little heart-wrenching, but it has to happen.
On this day, Copenharve is in the court to be part of Wolf's bond hearing and to push for tougher legislation.
It's sad that it takes a tragedy to realize the flaws in our laws.
The flaw, according to Copenharve, those who leave the scene of a serious accident like this can get a shorter sentence than those who stay and wait for police. So if convicted, Travis Wolf could spend less time in prison than Copenharve feels he deserves.
Saying that, yeah, you can have less punishment if you just leave. So we want that change for both sentences to be the same.
Copenharve is teaming up with Bob Schmill, who lost his son Matt in an Omaha hit and run nearly 6 years ago. Schmill spoke with us at the site where his son died.
It's going to be the same as other states have done it. And why is Nebraska always last to do things?
Schmill is pushing a new bill, LB 506, to change the law and wants it passed during this year's legislative session. But Schmill and Copenharve have been told by legislators it won't be brought up till next year.
It was kind of disappointing that it didn't happen this session, but we're going to keep fighting. It's not going to stop us.
Now, the bill would make it a felony to leave the scene of a fatal accident, punishable by up to 20 years in prison. Schmill says there's a massive outpouring of support for the plan, and he still hopes for getting it considered in this legislative session.
And Jeff, as far as this case goes, Wolf waived his preliminary hearing in the manslaughter case?
Yeah, correct. He will now stand trial in January for that hit-and-run case.
All right, Jeff Van Sant reporting live. Thank you, Jeff.